Hey YouTube, it's Sebastian, KF5OBS, and in case you've been wondering why I've been absent from YouTube for a while, you may find the answer in the background. I've been busy setting up a brand new lab at a brand new location, and moving takes a whole lot of time and I hate it. But anyway, I got my brand new lab set up, I'm ready to make lots of video for you guys. So in today's 20-second video, let's have a closer look at my brand new lab setup. Let's go. Alright, let's get started in this corner. As you can see, it's basically the old workbench that I had before. Got a little bit of more storage over there to the left. And as we move over, you're seeing a light that I use occasionally for stuff that's happening on the workbench and needs a little bit of extra lighting. And over here, you see my new setup has a nice shelf space. It's a relatively deep shelf space, so it's plenty even for the bigger power supplies and bigger test equipment. Right now I got all the scopes, the spectrum analyzer and things like that on the workbench itself. And I think this is a really nice setup. I got all the scopes there over to the right hand side and everything else over to the left. You can see there are a few new additions to the lab. There's LeCroy's brand new Wavesurfer 3000. I guess you've seen the Tektronix MDO before on the unboxing video, but it's still a brand new instrument. Then over there is a Tektronix frequency counter over to the right as well, up to 27 gigahertz, so quite a bit. Now I'm very happy with this setup because it gives me plenty of space to run multiple experiments at the same time. And that's something I was just unable to do beforehand. Even though the bench space itself didn't change, it's actually exactly the same. I have this additional shelf space and it really takes away or frees up a lot of room, and I'm very happy about that. Then a little bit over, got all my cables hanging there. It's very nice too to have all the test and measurement cables just hanging in a central spot and being able to grab them whenever I need them. And if I go down a little bit there, you see a 19-inch rack with 19-inch drawers, and that's where all my little cables, adapters, and those little things disappear to. They were previously just sitting on the workbench and taking up space. Then there's a little frequency generator. Well, I say little. It's a old one, but it's certainly not little, sitting to the left of that 19-inch rack. And I got a similar rack. If we go all the way over to the left again, right over there for all tools that I'm using in the lab here. A little bit right to that cable holder over there, I got a nice whiteboard. So that's gonna be something, if I have to explain basics, mathematics, or things like that, I have the ability now to draw things on a big whiteboard in the center of the room. That's a big help for me. Sometimes you just have to write things down, visualize them for yourself. But it'll also make one-on-one tutorials a whole lot easier to do. If you watch back in my video history, mostly I used a simple paper for that, and that just, I guess it worked, but I guess this whiteboard will be a whole lot better. We'll just have to see. And by the way, in contrast, that green on the wall is just nasty. I live in the United States, and Americans, at least here in the South, consider this snot green, how I like to call it, and poop brown to be neutral colors. I have no earthly idea why in the world they would do that. But as a matter of fact, if I would paint this white, which would be a whole lot better, or light gray or anything like that, the landlord would probably demand that I paint this back when I move out. And since I hate painting, for now I'm just gonna leave it alone. And I hope it doesn't bother you as much as it does bother me. Now anyway, let's pan over more to the right, and this is where my work area is, and let's tilt down a little bit. And this is basically the old setup. It's exactly the same workbench, desk and everything like that. I just added a third monitor, and I exchanged the monitors on the bottom too. They are bigger now, so I got a triple monitor set up, and I always thought I was spoiled with two monitors, but it turns out if you're doing lots of things at the same time, you will run out of space. So this triple monitor setup is definitely doing very well. If we move over to the right, we see the old radio setup. There's nothing new about this. And if you've seen my radio tour before, I don't know if I had all the scanners in there at that point in time, but if not, I have two APCO 25 capable scanners now. The top scanner is also a trunking scanner. but we actually have no systems in this region that use anything digital but EBCO 25. So I'm using the top scanner there on the right hand side for analog traffic only, like business frequencies, analog federal frequencies, amateur radio and that sort of stuff. And over on the left hand side you have my amateur radio sets, and as you can tell by that magnet mount antenna on the ASU 897, I do not have any external antenna set up yet. I have 30 feet of Rhone 25 tower laying behind the house, but I have not had the time. Well, actually that's a lie, I had the time, but I just haven't had the motivation yet to put that tower up. I will soon do that and wire all the wires out through the attic probably to the tower. And that's gonna be lots of work, but I'm looking forward to it. That's gonna be exciting, practical, hands-on work. And I replaced the audio mixer that I had beforehand with this over here. And if I actually move the chair out of the way, it can see it a whole lot better. So, the mixer is much bigger than the little one that I had beforehand. And on the bottom there, you see a tube, microphone preamplifier, two channels on the top. Then the bottom two devices are they're called compressors, but they're actually more than that in one. They are compressors, de-essers, peak limiters, and a bunch of other functions that I've probably forgotten in one. Each one of those 19-inch devices has two channels, so I have an overall of four channels. And if you look back up on the audio mixer, the first four channels have color-coded connectors that are sticking out, and that's the insert cables that go directly to those devices, to those four channels, four compressor channels. So the first four channels are going to be handled by those devices. And the reason why I bought this big mixer is not necessarily because of the additional channels, but because of the additional subgroups. I want to be able to put all my radios in one subgroup and then control the audio that actually goes to the radios also via the mixer. And then I'm gonna get a USB to 8-channel in and 8-channel out audio device in the mail shortly. That'll also go on the rack. And that way I'll be able to pull every single radio directly into the computer just for recording purposes and digital mode purposes. That's gonna be very exciting too. I have a patch bay coming in the mail also, and a bunch of other things, and I think I'll certainly make a video on this audio setup here. It's gonna be very exciting. Okay, that was just a little intro tour. I don't wanna bore you with lab tours and theoretical videos on what I might possibly do in the future. I thought it's time to just get down to do those videos, and you can expect videos at a much higher frequency than before on my channel. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't already, like this video, and if you have any requests for topics, just leave it down in the comment section or send me an email, and I will try to accommodate whatever is possible. Thank you very much. See you next time.